A very warm afternoon to one and all present here. What we see is what we believe, but what we touch is what is real. The embedded haptic eye is an embedded system that makes visually challenged to visualize the world through the sense of touch. Right from time immemorial, man has always had a thirst for innovation. He shaped the technology that reshaped his own destiny. Now, we have moved to such an extent where we even determine the time for which we live on this earth. But of what significance is all this technological innovation to a person who does not know what is ahead? Thereby, we dedicate this project of ours to the visually challenged.
This is how we plan to take our project forward. It is not the lack of vision that makes him feel disabled. It is the difficulty in carrying on the day-to-day activities which makes them feel uncomfortable. Now let us take a technology used to help a visually challenged person. The Braille technology helps him to learn, and the screen reading software helps him to interact with the environment, and the iCane integration itself involves a lot of physical and monetary constraints. None of these technologies satisfy the basic needs of a visually challenged person in terms of movement. It is this area we are here to give our solution.
So, what are we going to do? What is embedded haptic eye going to do? Our ultimate aim is to detect the presence of an obstacle and indicate the same to the user. So let us imagine a visually challenged person. He is walking on a road and there is an obstacle in front of him. Now, we have to give him all complete specifications of the object over there so that he will be able to take a very good decision. Now, this goal we have divided into 5 sub-goals. The first sub-goal is obviously to detect the presence of an obstacle over there. Once we detect the presence of an obstacle, we need to indicate the same to the user, and we do it by means of the haptic interface. Next, we proceed to get feedback from the user if he wants to know more about the obstacle over there. If yes, we give him more details of the obstacle. And finally, the user is equipped with all information that is necessary to make a correct decision.
We have split the working of our model into 2 modes, mode O, which stands for obstacle detection mode, and mode I, which stands for information mode. In mode O, we will be determining the presence of an obstacle and indicate the same to the user through vibration. In mode I, which stands for information mode, we will be specifying the type of the object to the user by calculating a density and indicate the same to the user by the use of 2 methods. One is the specimen pop-out method, another is the press switch method, which will be discussed in detail later. And this is the tabulated version of our mode of working.
Explains the working of our PIC processor. The PIC processor controls the operation of both the transmitter and the receiver. The transmitter and the receiver send data that contains the distance of the obstacle as also the power that is reflected from the obstacle to the PIC processor. The PIC processor transfers the data that contains the distance to the vibration control circuit. The vibration control circuit in turn activates a vibrator. The vibrator here is going to give vibrations that vary depending upon the distance. If the distance is less, then the vibration intensity is more. Now, there is also a power that is reflected. The data that is containing the power is given to a density value calibrator below. Now, we calculate the density from the power, and this density is compared against a standard set of values. We have got a stack that contains certain specimens, and the density is compared against the density of these specimens. Now, if a density match occurs, then the respective specimen is popped out, and the user is able to touch and feel the type of material. If there is a density mismatch, then we move on to the density to force converter. This density is converted to force, and the same is indicated to the user by means of the press switch. The press switch operation is quite simple. The press switch gives a hard resistance if the material is hard, and it gives no resistance or little resistance when the material is soft.
First model, it is similar to a walking stick, on the handle of which we are mounting a specimen pop-out and the vibration circuit, so that the user can use his thumb to feel the object which pops out from the specimen, and the vibration will be felt across his palm, which is more sensitive to vibration. We are also placed a press switch on the top of the handle, so that the user can use his thumb in order to press the switch and to see the type of the object. Now, and we have placed the 2 ultrasonic transceivers in such a way that the waves produced by each of them will not interfere with each other. They are placed at a distance of 0.6 meter apart from each other. Now, my friends will be explaining about the technology use.
We have now seen what the embedded haptic eye is capable of doing. Let us now see what exactly goes into the work of the embedded haptic eye. First is ultrasonics and echo sounding. We use the principle of ultrasonics and echo sounding in order to find the presence of an obstacle. Ultrasonics has been already employed in sonar technologies and is a very successful technology. Also, bats use it in the natural environment to move without any difficulties. Next is the haptic sense emulator. The haptic sense emulator is a device which stimulates the sense of touch of the user to pass on any information using the other parts to the user. All our haptic sense emulators here deal with the sense of touch alone because it is the most highly developed sense. Next is the embedded processor. Embedded processor is basically the heart of the system which controls the working of the above two technologies.
The property of the ultrasonic wave is that it gets reflected back when the density of the medium changes. The time difference between the transmitted ultrasonic wave and the reflected ultrasonic wave is used to calculate the distance of the obstacle. Next, our concern is to indicate the visually challenged person about the nature of the obstacle. We know that all the materials in this world have different densities. To calculate the density, we use two terms. One is the acoustic impedance and another one is the reflection coefficient. By using these two terms and compensating the atmospheric condition, we arrived at this result, where P is the density of the object under test, Z1 is the acoustic impedance of the material, PT and PR are the transmitted and received power, and V is the velocity of the ultrasonic waves in air.
We have now successfully found the presence of an obstacle and also identified what type of an obstacle it is. Our next task at hand is to provide these informations to the visually challenged person. How do we do this? We do this by using the sense of touch. The sense of touch is an active sense, as action always precedes perception. Here, the three haptic haptic sense emulators that we are using are the vibrator, which is used to provide a user an idea about the distance of the obstacle. Next is the press switch. A press switch is similar to a ball pen. Under normal circumstances, there is no opposition to the pressing clicking action. But if I block the mouth of the pen, I experience a lot of resistance in pressing the head. It is this basic principle that we use to indicate the user whether the obstacle is a hard or soft obstacle. This is only used when there is no density match. If a density match occurs, then we have the pop-out slots wherein a specimen corresponding to the density calculated is popped out of the slot so that the user can feel it with the thumb and identify the obstacle faced ahead. The next slide shows the circuit that we have used to implement the first mode alone.
The test case analysis is the comparison of the actual condition with the obtained result. We tested our sample for about 200 times and arrived at this result. While we are seeing, we can find that the error rate is high because we consider only less number of samples. But if we increase the number of samples for testing, I am sure that the error will be minimized.
Next, we move on to see some simulation results. These are simulation results that we have obtained using the software Wave 2000. Initially, Wave 2000 was a software that is used for non-destructive testing using ultrasonics. We implemented certain changes by including the noise reduction algorithms and flaw exclusion algorithm to make it suitable for our application. There are some observations that we can get from these simulations. One, whenever the transmitted and the reflected waves are observed, we find that for every range of densities, there is a unique wave which corresponds to a material in nature. Second, the little variation in density which might occur due to atmospheric interferences and other noises is compensated because the wave does not change by much. Thirdly, the values that we have calculated using the actual values in our formula correspond to the waves that we obtained using the software also. Finally, when we export these values as a text value or a picture and compare them under the real-time circumstances with the obtained waves, we can easily identify the density of the object from which it was emitted.
Other applications. This technology has been developed keeping in mind only the visually challenged person. With some slight modification, this idea can be implemented in other domain also. Here are some examples where we can implement our idea.
Dr. Goldrich, who has his PhD in assistive technologies, states that on an average, blind people are able to sight the smaller grooves better than other people. This and many other such results, which are main motivation for us, which made us to use the sense of touch as the primary interface with the user.
Since we use the sense of touch, so that it is user-friendly to the visually challenged person. They won't need any special training to use our model. And also our model is portable and it's of cheap cost around 1750 something. I am sure that it is feasible to the visually challenged person.
Finally, I would like to conclude by saying that seeing is only observing, whereas only touching is believing. This is the conclusion only to the paper and not to the project. You will not rest until it's completed.